And before we go, here's a story about pure dedication to the world's premier phone. A man from the Philippine province of Cebu beat out about 200 people who lined up, some overnight, in an Apple store in Makati to be the first to get their hands on the latest iPhone model, the iPhone 15. Joey Reyes says he arrived in Manila on October 13 just to be the first to line up during Friday midnight's launch. If his name sounds familiar, well, that's because Mr. Reyes was also the first to purchase the iPhone 14 in the Philippines, as well as the iPhone 11 in 2009 or 2019. Now, Reyes, along with the next 49 persons in line, were gifted with iPhone accessories worth 30,000 pesos for their efforts. In today's numbers that matter, 46%, are you among them? A new social weather station survey suggests this is the percentage of Filipinos who believe their quality of life will improve in a year. Take note. The study also says 44% believe it would stay the same, while 5% think it would go worse. SWS obtained these findings after polling 1,500 people nationwide from June 20 to July 1st. Moving on, IKEA Philippines expecting double-digit growth in the last quarter of the year. Its country sales manager reveals among the items driving their sales are storage, tableware, and food. The company has also expanded its deliveries to Visayas and Mindanao to help it reach its growth targets.
Right now, we can basically deliver through our parcel. What means parcel? We can deliver up to 40 kilos and a length of 1.8 meter, basically everywhere in Philippines. We have only one store. It's in IKEA Pasay City. We know sometimes can be difficult from accessibility perspective, but we still want to reach more of the many in Philippines everywhere, not only in Luzon area, but now we deliver, yes, to Visayas, to Mindanao, so to more than 7,000 items.
Telco giants PLDT and Smart warn subscribers of an uptick in fake advisories supposedly sent by banks and e-wallets. PLDT is urging customers to take time to scrutinize these fake advisories and to watch out for calls that claim to be from bank representatives. The telco reminds the public to verify the source of the supposed advisories, guard their personal information, as well as use strong, unique passwords, and to promptly report suspicious activities. PLDT said it has thwarted over 5.5 million smishing messages in September and blacklisted more than 21,000 mobile numbers involved in fraudulent activities. Millions of dollars worth of investment agreements signed during Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s visit to Saudi Arabia. Marcos also pitched the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund to investors in the Arab Kingdom. Rafael Borjano reports from Riyadh.
Following the arrival of the business delegation here in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, they were able to sign investment agreements with their Saudi counterparts that's worth millions of dollars. And in a business roundtable meeting with the business leaders here in Saudi Arabia, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says that thousands of Filipinos stand to benefit in terms of training and employment opportunities across a wide range of professions in the construction industry. He highlighted legislative amendments that the government has made in order to further open the economy to foreign investment. It is important, he says, to explore new businesses following an economy that was affected by the pandemic and to strengthen trade, telecommunications, energy, and even agriculture. Meanwhile, Saudi's Minister of Investment, Khalid Al-Fali, said they are excited about the future partnerships between the two nations and that they are open to discussing and collaborating on various sectors, including energy, chemicals, industry and logistics, tourism and even agriculture. Of course, one of the things that President Marcos also discussed was the Maharlika Investment Fund, where he says he looks forward to benefiting from the extensive experience of the kingdom in managing such funds. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno was also there to talk about how the investments in Maharlika are intended to quicken implementations of various infrastructure projects. Minister Al-Fali says that the meeting was held to precisely connect the Philippine delegation with Saudi investors who have success stories to share and a continuing desire to building presence internationally by investing in partners across the globe. That's just one of the activities outside the ASEAN-GCC summit, which is the main purpose of President Marcos's travel here to the kingdom.
War-torn Israel's credit rating at risk of a downgrade. U.S. ratings agency Moody's has put Israel's A1 credit rating on review for downgrade, citing the ongoing war with Hamas. Moody's adds, the severity of the conflict raises the possibility of longer-lasting and material credit impact. More than 5,000 have died in the violence. Moody's statement comes after Fitch Ratings announced Tuesday it was placing Israel's A+ foreign and local currency issuer default ratings on its ratings watch negative. Beijing putting the squeeze on graphite exports. The world's top graphite producer will require export permits for some graphite products beginning December 1st, citing the need to protect its national security. Graphite is used in batteries, including those for electric vehicles. China is enacting the curbs at a time when foreign governments are increasing pressure on their companies over their industrial practices. Top buyers of China's graphite include Japan, India, and South Korea. The Observatory of Economic Complexity, meanwhile, says the Philippines also gets its graphite imports primarily from China.